Unreal Engine is one of the best game engines available for developers for free. It gives an infinite abilities for developers, with pretty easy to understand toolset. Furthermore, it supports most graphical features just out of the box. Ray tracing, variety of AO techniques, reflections techniques, FSR and DLSS, volumetric fog and clouds, DirectX 12. And yeah, DirectX 12 is what I'm actually want to speak about. There is one thing in the engine no one pays attention on, but it is a very game-breaking thing, making the optimization of most of Unreal games with DirectX 12 as poor as possible. Hello, and welcome back to Hardware Lab. So let's check a few Unreal Engine 4 recent release titles. For example, here is the first run of Chernobylite on a really powerful mid-range PC with the Ryzen 3600 and the RX 6700 XT. The performance is pretty good, but the frame time graph is unstable. This is true for any PC build. It doesn't matter if you have a 5800X 3D or a Threadripper or a Core i9 or 6900 XT or whatever else. But if we look close to the frame rate drops, we will find an interesting regularity. All the drops are related to something new appears on the screen for the first time, no matter what is it, an enemy model, particle asset, or anything else. How this issue can be solved? Very easy, just run the same part of the game one more time, and the stability will be perfect. Yes, running same scene can be pretty smooth, just by rerun it again from the start. Of course we can blame FAM21 and say they did something wrong and their game is poorly optimized, but how can we ignore the fact that similar thing is happening in Ghostwire Tokyo, Final Fantasy VII Remake, Back 4 Blood and other Unreal Engine games? Well, of course I know what issue is related to. That's the reason of recording this video. Unreal Engine compiles shaders of course before building the actual build of the game. But using low-level APIs as DirectX 12 requires to compile some of the shaders especially for the particular setup that is going to run the game, which means the engine itself cannot compile them for every GPU that is present in the market. This makes developers leave the compilation process for the gamer's PC itself. If you check some games with the best usage of DirectX 12, you will notice a long loading before the first run. In some games like Horizon Zero Dawn, it is actually called as a shader compilation. In Forza Horizon 5, it is called optimization for your PC. And in Borderlands 3, it is just hided between typical loading screen. But all these games doing the compilation before load the actual gameplay scene. What about our example with Chernobylite? First start of the game just loads the game itself as fast as possible. That makes me think that the shader compilation process that is required for this game in DirectX 12 is just happening in real time, and this would explain why the second meeting with the same game content works well. Shaders for the second run are already compiled. Of course it is possible to use proper pre-compilation process on Unreal Engine, cause we see some games that doing this, but there is not too much information about that in the official guides and generally on the net. This is a strange thing for like most guided engine in the world? Before recording this video, I have contacted to one game developer from Russia that is developing his game called Vladik Brutal on Unreal Engine 4. He tested his game running under DirectX 12 against the X11, both worked in stock Unreal Engine conditions for his developer diary. And as you could imagine, there were no performance boost, even from the CPU side, with some strange in CPU load statistics. I'm not sure if exactly this issue is present here, but CPU is obviously doing some extra work, and it could be the shader compilation. Anyway, this example shows as well that something is wrong with Unreal and DirectX 12. Of course, not only Unreal Engine has some issues with shader compiling in low-level APIs. For example, recently released Elden Ring shares something similar as well running under DirectX 12. The story with this game is even deeper than you could imagine. Elden Ring was one of the flagman games that works well on Valve's Steam Deck. And of course compiling shader starters were even worse on Steam Deck than on regular PC build, both because of low-end CPU used on Valve's console and the Proton Die emulation level. performance were awful, and the frame pacing was making the game unplayable. However, Valve edited a pipeline for Proton Layer on SteamOS, and the additions contains already compiled shaders for Steam Deck. This is something impossible on PC platform, but this touch looks impressive, because exactly same Steam Deck machine now runs the games with brilliantly locked 30 FPS and excellent frame pacing. I don't really know what to address the developers in conclusion, but after research about whole situation with these awfully stuttering games, my only question is, why Epic Games ignore this issue? Don't get me wrong, Unreal is a great engine and probably the greatest. Unity and other competitors have nothing to hold well against Unreal, but this problem, it just makes me sad. And that's it for today. Stay up to date with HL.